Hey y'all, welcome back. Today we're going to be making twice baked sloppy joe baked potato. Hey, that rhymed. Let's go, y'all. Okay, so I got some russet potatoes here that I washed and cleaned and dried, just like you do your body. Okay, do that. Okay, don't use no dirty potatoes. They're going to be sopped up. They're going to talk about you in that group chat. You already know that. Okay, so we're going to bake these things. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to take some foil. I got my oven preheated to 450 degrees. I'm going to spray them with a little holy oil, honey, a little olive oil. Okay, put that up in there. If you got vegetable oil, then use that. Okay, just going to rub it, honey, until it gets nice and sopped up on that potato, okay? You want to make that skin nice and soft just in case you want to eat it. And then you know what we do on this channel, okay? We season. That's right. We're going to put a little salt on there, and then we're going to just put it in the foil, roll it up, honey, like baby Jesus in the manger, pop it in our oven, and we're going to cook this for about an hour until they're tender. Now, you can totally pop these potatoes in the microwave, honey, but don't do it in the foil, okay? Just pop in the microwave for a couple minutes, and they'll cook too, but I like them in the oven. I got my cast iron preheated here, y'all, medium heat. We're going to put our cellulite meat down in there, okay? Ground beef, huh? Y'all know ground beef like a little cellulite. That's okay. I can talk about it because I got two, okay? Real women issues. Praise God. We're going to break that up like that, y'all. You guys know that I like to let the ground beef just sit a little bit, get a little crust on the bottom, okay, before we flip it over. And in the meantime, while it's doing that, season that thing, okay? Put some seasonings up in there. You know, all the ingredients will be in the description box, so check that below. And I'm going to swirl that around like that. I'm going to break it up, okay, because I don't want chunks of meat like that. I want a nice size, but I don't want it too chunky. So break it up, okay, and strain it. Get that fat up off of there. You don't want to give nobody no heart attack. Then once it's strained, remove it from the heat and strain it. I'm sorry. Then we're going to add our vegetables. I added some bell pepper and onion to that pan, okay? Got a little bit of oil in there so it won't stick. And then we're just going to saute our vegetables like this right here, all right? So they're kind of translucent and tender. Maybe about 5 minutes, y'all. Then I'm going to add some tomato paste to the pan. Just like that, super simple. You wanna let that tomato paste sit for just about 30 to 45 seconds, and we're gonna allow it to bloom, okay? To kind of release the oils and all that stuff. So let it just sit there for a minute, and you wanna grab your tomato sauce. I like Hunt's, okay? No, this is not sponsored, but hey, if y'all wanna sponsor me out there, Hunt's, come on, cut the check. Praise God. All right. And then we're going to just stir that around. We're going to add that sauce and stir it around and combine it with the tomato paste. Okay. Get that nice and sopped up, child. All right. I'm still on medium heat, y'all. I'm going to use my favorite barbecue sauce. I think this sauce is sopped up. I like it. It's Sweet Baby Ray's. Okay. And at this point, we are just going to do everything to taste. This is about maybe about 3/4 to one cup. Mm-hmm. Yeah, about a cup of barbecue sauce. Then we're going to add a little Worcestershire up in there. Okay. A little Lee and Perkins up in there. Okay, put that up in there, not too much, just a few dashes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah, dashes up in there, okay? Then we're gonna add some Better Than Bouillon. I like this, I think it give it rich flavor, be so good, y'all, season it too, so be careful not to use too much. All right, but you can add the bouillon powder, they sell it in the store too, bouillon powder, add that to that, okay? Then we're gonna add some garlic powder, and then we're gonna add some onion powder, okay? Make sure you season, okay? Season about a tablespoon of garlic powder, tablespoon of onion powder. Then we're gonna add some chili powder, about a tablespoon of that, and then we're gonna add a seasoning that I don't really like to use a lot. It's cumin, okay? I feel like it's musty, okay? It's make your food smell musty and stuff, but it do add a good flavor to it, okay? If you use it right, add a little cumin to that thing, and then we're gonna add some sugar. Not too much, cause baby, we ain't making no meat cobbler, okay? But want a little sugar in there to balance all the tomato tanginess, okay? Then we're gonna add our say like meat ground beef, thank you, right there. You see it ain't too chunky, okay? You want it a nice texture, y'all, but not too, you don't want to make it like Salisbury steak. I ain't got time. Stir that around like that till it get nice and combined with that tomato sauce, okay? Then we're going to bring it to a boil about medium heat, and then we're going to put a lid on there and let that thing cook for about 15 minutes, okay? It's going to get nice and thick. That's how we want it. All right, the potatoes are done. We're going to take them out the oven, put them over there, let them cool down for about 10 minutes before you open that thing up, baby. And let me tell you something. Be careful to open up that foil, baby, okay? Because if you do it when it first come out that doggone oven, you're going to be holding up the Crip sign for sure, okay? It's going to take them fingers right off. Don't do that, okay? Give it a little space, a little time, a little opportunity to cool on down, okay? Because baby, that thing will blow you off like an angry black woman. I'm trying to tell you, at a protest or at a red light that you done tried to flick off or cut off. Don't do that. Open that potato up, okay? And then you're going to put it in a bowl right here. I got a little bowl. I'm just going to scoop the potato out, y'all. Be careful with this, okay? Because you want to keep the shape of the potato skin. So I'm just going to scoop the potatoes out. I use two potatoes, okay? Dos potatoes. And then I'm going to put some butter up in there, okay? You know you got to add the South's delicacy, honey. Put that butter up in there. Then we're going to add some cheese. I'm using Colby Jack and some cheddar, all right? Put that up in there. Then we're going to add some sour cream, honey, okay? Make your mouth pop and your neck snap, get a little tanginess. Basics that you use for a baked potato, okay? Actually, this is a two-in-one recipe. So y'all getting two recipes today in one video because I love y'all. Go add some food grass up in there, a little parsley for a little color. And you know we gotta season it, okay? So you wanna add some garlic powder in there and a little bit of salt. Not too much, cause you know that meat that we're gonna put on top of that is gonna be seasoned already. Then you just want to fold that around in there. I don't want no like mashed potatoes, okay? So fold it around so it can keep its texture. All right, then look at that. The meat is done. Look nice and thick and so delicious. Ooh, it's so good, y'all. You can eat this on a bun, some bread, or some potato chips, child, okay? Put this on a flip-flop and eat this. Still gonna be soft, dude. All right, look at that. That look good right there. It's ready to go. Now we got our potato skins here. Now we're just going to put our Sloppy Joe mix into those potato skins, okay? Then we're gonna top it with some cheese. That's right. Okay, make that thing good. Put some cheese up in there, okay? Put that little potato back there, get some cheese. Then we're gonna add that potato topping, half of the potato topping, okay? On there, put a little bit on the other potato. Then we're gonna add more topping of the meat. That's right. You know how we doing on this channel? Stop playing with me. Okay, put that up in there, make it soft up. Look at that. Look at that meat dripping. Boom. Woo. Child, that was so good. I had it. It was delicious. Okay, then we're going to add just a little bit more of the topping that we had left over, y'all. All right, then we are going, because we layered this potato. Don't it look good? We're going to top it with some cheese. We're going to put it into our broiler on high or medium. On low for about 10 minutes or so, okay? No, I'm sorry, 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Don't put it in there for 10 minutes. 5 minutes. And when it comes out, it looks just like this. Just want to get the cheese nice and melted. Then we're going to put some food grass on there like that, y'all. And that looks so cute. We're going to take a cute picture for Instagram. Boom, there it is. You see it. And we're going to dive in. Y'all, this is so good. And it's a perfect recipe for the weekend. And it is also the perfect recipe to make and eat while you watch my new podcast, our new podcast, Grown Folks Business, that is coming out on tomorrow, y'all. First episode, our intro episode, dropped tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, y'all. We have such a good time. Look how we over there just laughing and kicking it. We're going to be talking about some real stuff, y'all. And I'm telling you, it's highly entertaining. So please tune in tomorrow at 7 o'clock for Grown Folks Business. It's going to be a good time. Make this recipe, okay? And watch us tomorrow night on this channel. It's going to air on this channel, y'all, okay? And you'll be able to find it where all podcasts are streamed, y'all. Thank you guys so much for watching. Later.